Good morning, students. This is my lecture number 1 for chapter number 4, The Rat Trap from Flamingo book for class 12th subject English. And the chapter The Rat Trap is written by Selma Lagerlöf. Today, we shall cover the syllabus of this chapter given on page number 32 to 36. And I will assign you homework related to the lesson to be taught now. We shall cover the following highlights of the chapter: its theme, its characters, and how this story was set. First of all, I shall tell you the theme of the chapter. In this theme, I'll tell you about the generosity of the young woman who transformed the staunch heart of the paddler, the pessimistic attitude of the paddler about the world as well. Actually, the story is about an old disheartened paddler who is taken in and shown generosity by a young woman. Her generosity and kindness change his bitter attitude towards life. The paddler is a man who has fallen upon misfortune and now resorts to selling rat traps. Sometimes he resorts to selling, begging, and thievery as well. He is very pessimistic about the world and sees the world as merely a rat trap. He believes that the story tempts us with riches and fine things, and when we accept them, we are caught in the trap and are left with nothing. Now, we shall proceed to the characters of the story. The story has a paddler with rat traps, an old man who is a crofter, the master smith in the Ramso iron mill in Sweden, his helpers in the mill who are known as blacksmiths, iron mill owner, and the most important, Edla Wilmensen, the daughter of the iron mill owner. Now, setting of the story. This story is set amidst the mines of Sweden, rich in iron ore, which figure large in the history of that country. The story is told somewhat in the manner of a fairy tale. In this chapter, we shall cover the value points like the vagabond, the paddler's business, the paddler's idea of the world being a rat trap, his shelter at crofter's house, the incident that happened at the crofter's house, the idea of falling into a rat trap, and the paddler's arrival at the Ramso ironworks. And the first value point is the vagabond, the paddler's business. First of all, I want to tell you the meaning of vagabond. The vagabond means the wanderer, the hawker. So, once upon a time, there was a man who went around selling small rat traps of wire. He made them himself at odd moments, and he became a beggar because he had nothing to make rat traps of his own. Therefore, he arranged the material by begging in the stores or at the big farms. But even so, this business of selling rat traps was not especially profitable, so he had to resort to both begging and petty thieveries to keep his body and soul together. His clothes were in rags. His cheeks were sunken. Sunken means falling inward. And the hunger gleamed in his eyes. The next value point is the paddler's idea of the world being a rat trap. No one can imagine how sad and monotonous life can appear to such a vagabond who plods along the road, left to his own meditations. But one day, he fell into a line of thoughts which made him struck by the idea that the whole world was nothing but a big rat trap. Its riches, Its villages, its seas are nothing but a big rat trap. It had never existed for any other purpose than to set baits for people. It offers riches and joys, shelter, food, heat, clothing, exactly as the rat trap offered cheese and pork. And as soon as anyone let himself be tempted to touch the bait, it closes it on him and then everything comes to an end. The world becomes nothing but a rat trap for everyone. There are many who are caught in this dangerous snare, but there are others who are still circling around their bait, and the day is not far, everybody will get caught into this rat trap. Let's move to the next value point, that is shelter at Crofter's house. The world had never been kind to this peddler, therefore he wanted some shelter at someone's place. And one dark evening, he was wandering along the road. He caught sight of a little grey cottage by the roadside and he knocked on the door to ask shelter for the night. Nor he was refused. Instead of the sour faces which ordinarily met him, the owner of the house, who was a crofter, gave him shelter. In fact, the crofter also felt happy to get a company of this peddler. The reason behind this crofter lived alone. He had no one in his family. Therefore, he felt happy that there would be someone to spend a night with him there at his own hut. Then he became very generous and shared everything with the peddler, even the secret of the earning and the livelihood. What he did, he immediately put the porridge pot on the fire and gave him supper. Then he craved off such a big slice from his tobacco roll that it was enough for both the stranger's and his own. Finally, he got an old pack of cards and started playing a card game with him. The old man was just as generous with his confidence as with the porridge and the tobacco. The guest was informed at once that in his days of prosperity, his host had been a crofter at Ramso Iron Works and had worked on the land. Now, he was no longer able to do day labor. Therefore, it was his cow which supported him for his livelihood. He told the peddler that he had received all of 30 kronor in his payment the last month. The stranger must have seemed incredulous for the old man. Therefore, he got up, went to the window, took down a leather pouch which hung on a nail in the very window frame and picked out 3 wrinkled 10 kronor bills. These he held up before the eyes of his guest, nodding knowingly, and then stuffed them back into the pouch. This was the secret of his earning that he shared with the peddler. Let's proceed to the next value point, that is the incident that happened at the crofter's house. Departure of the peddler and the crofter in the next morning. The next day, both men got up in good season. The crofter was in a hurry to milk his cow, as the other man probably thought he should not stay in bed when the head of the house has gotten up. They left the cottage at the same time. The crofter locked the door and put the keys in his pocket. The man with his rat trap said goodbye and thank you, and thereupon each went his own way. Then, after some time, the peddler came back and he stood again before the door of the crofter. He did not try to get in. However, he only went up to the window, smashed the pane, struck his hand in and got hold of the pouch with the 30 kronor. He took the money and thrust it into his own pocket. Then he hung the leather pouch very carefully back in its place and went away. Now we shall move to the next highlight of the chapter, that is the idea of falling into a rat trap. After the man stole money from the cottage of the crofter, he fell into a line of thought. He remembered his own words. As he had the stolen amount in his pocket, he could not go from the highway. He walked along with the money in his pocket. He decided to choose the jungle way. During the first hours, this caused him no difficulty because it was daytime. Later in the day, it became worse for him. It was a big and confusing forest which he had got fallen in. He tried to be sure to walk in a definite direction, but the paths twisted back and forth so strangely. He walked and walked without coming to the end of the wood. Finally, his realization of his own impenetrable prison from which he could never escape. All at once, he recalled his thoughts about the world and the rat trap. Now he realized as if his own turn had come. He had let himself be fooled by a bait and had been caught. The first and the whole forest with its trunks and branches, its thickest and fallen logs, closed in upon him like an impenetrable prison from which he could never escape now. It was late in December. The darkness was already descending over the forest, and this increased the danger again and again into his gloom and despair. He felt very sad. He became monotonous because he had no way out to come out of this jungle. And again he was realizing the mistake that he had committed at the crofter's house. The stolen amount did not allow him to go from any other way, and this jungle way had confused him a lot. Therefore, he could not find his way out of this jungle. The another highlight of the chapter is the paddler's arrival at the Ramso Ironworks. The paddler was very much sad as he had lost his way into the jungle, and he laid his head down onto the ground. Then the paddler heard the sound of hammer strokes from an iron mill. Though he was very weak to walk, but he summoned all his strength and followed the direction of the sound. And he somehow staggered into the direction and reached the Ramso Iron Works, which are now closed down, were not so long ago a large plant with smelter, rolling mill and forge. Then he found the mill, and there he requested for the shelter. The blacksmiths who were present there, sitting in front of the big forge, were just waiting for the raw material to come. This vagabond requested them to allow him to take one day shelter, and the blacksmiths nodded a haughty consent. This showed this croft peddler that he was agreed to give him the shelter. Haughty means arrogant, but he was happy because he wanted only a shelter of the night. Students, this is the end of the lecture here. We have covered this chapter up to page number 36. In my next lecture, I shall proceed further with the explanation of rest of the pages left of this chapter. And homework of the day is, think as you read, given on page number 34, with a set of questions from question number 1 to 6 are to be answered on the basis of your understanding. Thank you. Have a nice day.